everybody. So today I want to paint the Paint With Me challenge that is hosted by Susan Chung for the month of June. So she has selected that we will be painting this image by the beautiful Mina Kim. So this is from Unsplash. I will leave link to the reference photo underneath here. So or underneath this video. So I'll just put that in front of me. I have my Winsor & Newton cold press paper, 300 gm. I have just cut a piece or one of the sheets in half. I have a regular cutting mat, so I will just tape my paper on my cutting mat. I just use some regular masking tape. And since this is cellulose paper, the tape will usually stick quite hard. So I'm kind of just dabbing this tape on my either my pants or my top, so that I get the lid of just like readily. Fast, just so that I get the lid of the or the stickiness is being reduced. So hopefully it won't be, or it won't rip my paper when I remove this tape. That is my little trick. And of course, if it does stick when I'm or going to take it off, then I will heat it with my hair dryer. I don't have a heat tool, so I just use a regular hair dryer. So there, I have taped it on, so we get this nice white border around it like a frame. I like that. The paint I'm using today is just my regular or my small Mrs. & Newton set, cut my set. Now I have switched out some colors, of course. So yeah, but this is all Cotman paints. Some of them are the professional range, but there is Winsor & Newton. So, because for this image, we can see here, it is blue and green mostly, and of course the clouds are white, but for the white we just use the paper. So we need greens and blues, and we also, yeah, let me show that as well. We can see that it is a little bit darker on the top of the sky here, and it's getting lighter down there. So we will try to make a gradient from dark to light down here, and the green that we have here is also both light and dark, and the green that we are in or see in between has quite a lot of yellow in it. So it is light and dark blue, light and the dark green, and that's it. I have 2 jars of water, one with a makeup sponge in the bottom just for easy cleaning, and I use a porcelain palette because I prefer that when I'm mixing. I will just take my big brush, yeah, and the brushes I'm using, I'm having 3, one big, one medium, and one small. All of these are the silver black velvet. You don't have to use exactly these ones, but it is nice to have kind of decent brushes. I will say, oh, come on, camera, that you should buy cheap paint, some decent brushes, and put the rest of your money in the paper, because it is the paper that actually is important when you are watercoloring. So first up, I will just wet my entire paper. I have a Sabere bottle, actually a small one of these, made for travels, that I'm just put water in, and I'm using to separate my paintings. So I'm wetting the paper quite nicely, trying to spread this water on kind of evenly. Then I will just let that sit for a little while. Now you can see that it is really wet because it is so shiny. As it dries, it will lose the shininess. I will have here some light yellow. I have this sapphire from the Bin Serendipin. I will mix a little bit more, which is a really nice yellowy green. If I want it to be more yellow, I can of course just pick up some of this yellow that I have here. No, this isn't a really yellow, that is actually yellow ochre. So picking up some of that, putting that in there so that I'm getting a more yellowish green. Second up is a darker green. So this is the Hooker's Green Dark. So quite thick and nicely piece of that. Like that. So cleaning my brush. The paint that I have in that well or that color, that is what Vincent and Newton calls intense blue. I think it's kind of like a ultramarine, actually. If you have a cerulean, that is nice as well. Here I have some really, really dark blue. That is actually the cobalt blue mixed with some neutral tint. Neutral tint. The neutral tint pigment makes every other color darker. I have that color, that neutral tint, actually in all of my palettes because it's such a handy watercolor to have, a pigment to have. I also have a rag. Now this is actually, it's dry. I should go and dampen it, so I will be right back. So now my rag here is damp. I'm using that to wipe my brush off and maybe we will lift out some clouds if we need to. So I'm taking my big brush, and now my paper is you can still see that it is shiny, just less shiny. So I will try to zoom you guys in a little bit, so maybe let's see. Let me see if I can push some of this aside so that you get to see the palette. Now several people do like to see the palette as well. Can we make this work? Yeah. I don't know where to put this little thing. Just put it on the side there. That will have to do. So picking up some of that blue that we have, that intense blue, or if you have a ultramarine or even cerulean. Now mine is kind of dark, so I'm just painting around these clouds, actually. We should need picking up some more water over here, making that float out a little bit. Then we should try to pull some of that blue further down here. So we are getting some kind of a gradient, really. Picking up some more color because I want it to be more blue up here. Oh, we don't have any clouds on that side, actually. So I'm just picking that up, cleaning it off with a quite wet Others, I'm just trying to pull some of this further down. Taking some more of a water. Watercolor needs water to pad Evelyn. So, now I got the hair in there. Let's see if I can. Oh my god. Yeah, there, I got it off. So, maybe I will put even more of that darker up here. Even pick up some of that mixed so that we get it really dark. That blue with that neutral tint, so that almost looks black in my palette. We'll just put that there. Let me just some in between, cleaning it off. There. I will just take in my damp rag. You can use a kitchen towel or some tissue paper, or tissues might crumble, but some kitchen paper like that maybe. Do we have of course I won't copy the clouds exactly, but we have this one kind of big one here moving this way. And then we have a smaller one, or actually two smaller ones on top. So I have mine up there. Now mine, that smaller one for me, there are a little bit bigger. But we can separate it with, I'm just picking up my medium brush here. And just, we can just add some to there. Something like that. Can put a little bit more color there. Maybe just to enhance the color of the. And I'm so sorry, but I have to send these. Oh, bless me. Today the pollen has been really bad, so I have like even taken two of my allergy pills, but yeah. I don't know if I actually like that part there. Maybe pick some of that blue up and just. No, I should leave it alone and stop fiddling with it, because when you are fiddling with it and adding more, that is when you are doing it, and you. Or at least I do. I overdo it. So I'll do that. So I'm taking out my big brush again. My big now. This is a number 12, so that is quite a large one. I will start cleaning it off and pick up some of that yellowish green and just put that at the bottom. Now this scenery starts off at a low point to the left, and then move or go, and then going upwards towards as you come to the right side. So again, I will not copy it exactly, and this is a painting, so I'm just giving an impression of it. So I picked up this darker green that I have here. And I will dab in that teddy line, so I'm just dabbing, dab. So something like that. We also have some part of that forest down here, of course. We can No, this is just the first. Today we will go in and put some more somewhere on there. And darken up this and put in more this and all. So this is just the first layer. Now that part got really really light. I just put in some more pigment. So then I will let that dry, and then I will come back. So now my painting is dry. I'm quite or kind of happy with my scar, so I don't think that I will fuss in it more about it. Or I don't know. I don't like that hard edge here. So maybe we should try to do something with it. So I'm just taking some clean water and I'm just kind of massaging it into my paper again in that, that space there. Taking my towel or my old rag and lifting that up. Maybe we can see if we can give it some movements, because to me that line was just too hard, and I saw that my cloud looked more square really. So I want to soften that out a little bit, making a little bit more of kind of bubbly things. Yeah, now I like that better. Maybe put a little end and just manipulate and yeah, that sky just a little bit more of that cloud. Yeah, now I think that is good. Now I will leave my sky. Well, of course we also have some hard lines up there, so again just clean water. Let me just put in that down there, wiping it off of my towel, trying to soften that up a little bit. Let me just dab it with my damp towel to make those clothes more fluffy like. And that, yes, that is a technical term, fluffy clouds. Or actually I think they are called cotton candy clouds or something, but anyways, picking up some of that darker green, so and just putting in our teddy line here. Let me just starting doing that. Come on, we need more paint. Just some of that dark there. Of course, I should. I think I need to mix up some more of that lighter green. We're just picking up some clean water in my glitter. Yeah. Then I'm just putting that wet light green color into or next to the wet teddy line there. And we're just softening that out, bringing that down, and putting some of that darker down there. Come on. Like that. So I'm not being even, I'm exactly the opposite. So I need to darken up the bottom part of the or the teddy line. So I'm taking some of that dark blue actually. I'll just dab that in. At the bottom here. And again, I'm so sorry that I am so sniffly. Pick some of that. Okay. I mixed up the two little color. So some of that darker. There. I think we need some down here. Again, something like down there. Now we do have a small road in our painting, so I will actually try to lift some of that up out. I have a little square badass here, which is just a taclon, I think that is what it's called, nylon badass. This one is quite stiff, so it is good for lifting. So I'm just wetting it or making sure that it is damp, and then I will just drag it along my page here like that, and I'm wiping it off in between again like that. Yeah, that maybe it goes up there and disappear in that forest up there. So maybe we should add some darker trees as well actually. So we have some of that hooker's dark green there, and I'm picking up that dark blue. Green is a mix between blue and yellow. If you want it darker, just add more blue. I want this contrast to kind of stand out a little bit. But do you think that I will need to dye my paper again, because now it is just really floating into each other. So I will again let this dye. And I will be right back. Okay, now this is completely dry. And I really like how this is going. But I think that maybe I should put in some individual trees. Now, of course, we can't really see that in this distance. But we can kind of point out some. So I'm switching to my smallest badass here, putting it down and just make some small lines up, and then I'm just squiggling it down that. Then one line, and then so. And just again some small here and there. Not really making trees, it's just an impression of it. We have a couple, okay, down there. So one line down, some scribble to the sides. Maybe we need one down there, like that. This darker and just darken up that tree line that we have here. Just dabbing it down. Actually, I shouldn't go over there, but we should kind of make it look like that road is going behind those trees there and coming. Anyways, I'm just darkening up this teddy line that we actually see here. Just pick put in some lines going upwards. So that it is an impression of trees. That is to say, big forest. Not too shabby. Close this one. Put my palette to the side here. So let's compare this to the reference photo that we had. We have. Oh my god, it disappeared. Where are you? There. So this is our reference photo. Hopefully you can actually see the colors in it. Now it looks quite darker on my screen than what it really is. So this is what we painted. I think we did good. And painting skies with clouds and all that is just so much fun, and it can be so therapeutic. So now we will reveal our masterpiece. I'm just taking a tape and I'm always tearing it away from my painting, not inwards towards it, because if some of this paper is stuck and won't let go, then I will rip the paper going away from my painting and not ripping it in towards the painting. So I'm always tearing it away from the painting. Like that. There. Da-da. So this is ready to be signed off and posted for the June Paint PaintWithMe challenge. I will of course link to PaintWithMe challenge. Susan Chung's website and to her Instagram account, and also to Unspallash and this reference photo. So this is such an easy and fun painting to do. So even if you are all new, you should be able to do this. And if it doesn't work out the first time, just make another and just have fun. So this should be manageable for most of us. So until next time, stay safe, take care, and I love you all. Bye.